A pneumatically operated rod butt welder. On this you can weld rods from 16mm to 20mm dia, MS and high carbon wire rods. First of all, you have to connect the main supply, two lines of three phase, 100 amperes, one neutral and one earthing, by opening the back cover and connecting this cable. Then you have to connect this side 5 kg per centimeter square air over here. This here is a main clamping pressure gauge. On this you can set the pressure, say about 4 kg per centimeter square. This here is an air filter. This one here is an air lubricator. You have to fill the oil over here by opening this key and then filling this lubricator up to this level. Then you can close this bolt over here. This here is the welding pressure gauge. You can adjust the pressure, say about 2.5 kg per centimeter square, with the help of this knob like this, and then tighten so that nobody can fiddle with this. This over here, solenoid valve for welding. This over here is a solenoid for clamping. These two are the pneumatically operated clamping cylinders. These are the clamping jaws. These are the welding jaws. And water cooling is given over here under the welding jaws. Here you have a electronic controller. This over here is a welding cylinder. Now this switch over here is a timer on off switch. You can make it on when you want to operate the machine. This here is a no weld and weld switch. When you want to weld the rod, put this on the weld side. When you don't want to weld, put it on the no weld side. This over here is a percentage heat for butt welding the rods. That can be adjusted depending upon the dia of the rod. Supposing you want to weld 16mm dia rods, keep it at say 90% heat. This over here, the squeeze weld means clamping time for the clamping cylinders. This over here is the total time for the one operation of the welding. This is the squeeze two time, that is for clamping welding the jaw. This over here is a weld time that you can adjust, say keep it say number 3, say 30 cycles. And this here is a forging 2, that again you keep at number 30 cycles. Now the machine is ready for operation. We'll show you the welding. Thank you. you clamp the rods in such a way so that they touch each other in midway of the two welding jaws. Then put the no weld weld switch towards the weld side. Now you can press the foot switch. You will see the welding taking place and the current cutoff will be automatic. Now the welding is over, it will be automatically, the cylinders will go out. You can take out a job. See, this is how it is welded. Now you can anneal the job by clamping the welded rods again in the same welding jaws, taking this annealing switch towards top, and then by pressing this annealing switch. See, this is how it is annealed. Now you can take out the job. And carry on the next process.